Hello everyone, this is Kathy from Divine Debut. This is your first half of May 2018 general and love reading. For the readings, I will be using the Gilded Reverie Lenormand, the expanded edition. I will also be using my La Vera Sibylla for more information. And I will also have the Pictorial Key Tarot, which is a new deck that I have bought, and it is by David Corsi. And last readings, I did introduce the 3D Tarot, which is also, it's the same edition, it's the same type of card, but obviously the 3D deck was made as a special edition because it is only the Major Arcana. So I did introduce these last readings. I will be using the David Corsi Tarot, Pictorial Key Tarot. Okay, so they're a smaller version of the 3D. And for those of you that are interested in the astrology part, I will upload a video just on the astrology for those of you that that are not interested in astrology. So I will be, the general readings will be without the astrology part, okay? Only tarot. So they can be nice and quick. All right. Thank you very much. Hello, Virgo. Welcome to Divine Debut. This is Kathy speaking, and this is your May 1st to the 15th, 2018 love and general reading. I'm doing these readings the same as the April readings, but I'm not doing reversals today. So let's see what the universe has in store for you in the month of May. Do know that with Uranus moving into Taurus, it will be affecting the earth signs especially. So 15th of May is a very important date. Let's see what happens on or around there for Virgo, Virgo spirit guides and angels. Okay, this card wants to come out. Well, Four of Wands. That is the now position. It just stayed in my hand, so I had to take it. Okay, so in the now position is the Four of Wands. In the distant past, we have the Five of Wands. In the recent past, I should move the cards up so you can see them. In the recent past, we have the King of Cups. Crowning your reading is the Chariot, which is the card of Cancer. So most of you are dealing probably with a Cancerian male. Or female, doesn't matter, it's a general reading. And in the near future, oh my God, Virgo, the Queen of Cups. Okay, whatever this is two people that are meant to be together. Is meant to be. Now, I'm not reading reversals, but it's all about the home. This is Cancer here. Cancerian individuals, more than likely Cancer. Or it could be Pisces. I mean, you are your opposite sign. Your descendant, dear Virgo, is Pisces. So let's see what the Major Arcana is going to be from the Tarot 3D, the general energy. Okay, here we go. Oh my God, dear Virgo, we've got the Empress. How beautiful. The Empress. She's all about manifestation. You can't see her there. She's all about manifestation, abundance, loving, nurturing energy. Now she is showing us the sign of Venus here. Venus is the ruler of Taurus and Libra. So for me, the Empress mostly speaks of Taurus and Libra. Now, you could have your sun, moon, or rising, or your partner may have their sun, moon, or rising in one of these signs. Also, it's a number three. Threes speak of expansion. Now, the tummy could be expanding. Some of you, congratulations, you are falling pregnant. Wow, we've got the home. We've got the happy home celebration here, partying, taking the relationship to the next level. My God, we've got in the distant past the Five of Wands. Now, fives always speak of external things coming in to bring change. It could be five people involved here not being on the same page, or they may be trying to build on something. Let's say if you are a family of five, maybe you are trying to grow your family. Maybe there's five of you and you want one more family member to go up to the six. Whatever that means, we've got fives, as I said, they have a conflictual sort of energy, but fives can bring in change. So we've got wands and more wands here. Passion. Passion, of course, creative. Something, beginning something new, celebrating something that is that you have nurtured and grown. So if this is a business, there is some sort of celebration here with something that you've been very creatively working on, right? Because the Empress is a number three, yes? Three is the initial point of success, but there is more to come. Now, the Empress is also a time of harvest, right? Harvest in the northern hemisphere would be September, roughly around there, right? What am I saying? Even, I mean, July, August, September. So this could be when you are manifesting, and we do have the seven here, the card of Cancer. Now, in the southern hemisphere, so let's say summer. Okay, if you are in the southern hemisphere, we are talking about roughly the end of the year, right? So the 11th month, the 12th month, and January. That's what I'm just picking up, you guys. So the time of Sagittarius beginning from then, if you are in the southern hemisphere, right? So we've got a number four here, which is the number of the House of Cancer. The House of Cancer speaks of family. Now we've got two individuals here. This could be you and your partner. Okay. Now, as you could see, it looks as though, and I feel as though this is your partner, right? He is holding out the cup, so is she. If this is your energy, it could be the other way around, right? Depending on if you're female or male. But as you can see, it looks as though she's putting up her cup. She is going to propose something. They are proposing, and the word proposal comes up here. Congratulations for those of you that are going to be abundant with anything to do with either a pregnancy or something literal or metaphorical that has been sown, the seeds have been sown. It could have been in the month of March that this began, right? Because she to me is a woman who is pregnant 3 months. Or it could have been 3 months ago. So we're in May now, so that's the 5th month. It could have started in February. Whatever happens, let's say 6 months from now, we are at the 11th month, which is the time of Sagittarius. That could be important to you. But I believe that you are overcoming whatever obstacles in the month of July because this is a number seven and it is the time of Cancer, which is in July, end of June and July. So overcoming obstacles, this could be a literal movement. And I notice the star on top of his head. It looks like a star and it could be the sun as well because it is daytime. The sun is what the heart loves. It's Leo. And also Aquarius comes to mind. So there could be someone at a distance. that you may be traveling. Some of you may be going on a holiday to a warm climate, celebrating your love, your honeymoon, whatever this is. Virgo, this is just glorious. Let me take a Gilded Reverie, Lenormand. I would like to look at what this celebration is all about, the now position. Now, it is the now position, but it could be in four. This celebration could be taking place in 4 weeks. Oops, there's the card. Look at that. Another four. Another four, which speaks of Cancer. It speaks of home, stability. Wow, the family. The fourth house is the house of Cancer, which speaks of the family. That is beautiful. Let me take a Lenormand on the Empress. You do need to trust your intuition. If this is your energy here, the Queen of Cups, yes, she can be quite emotional as well, but she is a queen. You've got your king here, and it says that you can and you feel that it's going to be a beautiful 2 weeks for you. You may have the inclination in the next 2 weeks of what is panning out in your future. And I did say up until the time of Sagittarius. There's the card. It just flipped open. Let's see. There it is. Oh, my God. There's the gift, the flowers. This is absolutely beautiful. This could mean an engagement, a wedding, whatever. This is a gift from the universe. Virgo. And you know what? It's a number nine. Number nine is Sagittarian, the Sagittarian house in the natural horoscope, but it's also, what was I going to say? The ninth month, which is September, which is your birthday, dear Virgo. I think in the previous readings, again, this was mentioned, your birthday month. And there is a cue here, whatever that means for you. Now, this could mean in 9 months from now for some of you, but it could also, I mean, 9 months to pregnancy is 9 months. Some of you may be starting now and you may be having a child in the month of September, which could be a Virgo. No, I'm going to look at the Sibylas right now. I would like to look at King of Cups. What's going on with this King of Cups? Oh my God. On the house, there is a K here. I forgot to mention that. K. So what's this king here? Alegría. Alegría. That's merriment and happiness. Going out and celebrating. Superbia can be a card of vanity and pridefulness, but also it is something wonderful, right? It's the peacock that is showing its beautiful feathers, so it's very prideful. And, you know, male peacocks, they will fight if they are threatened. They fight very hard. They want to be boss. So maybe you are dealing with someone who is the boss. Maybe this is someone who is a business owner, someone who calls the shots. And we've got the Sospiri, which is like the Three of Wands for me. Remember before I said whatever you have planted, you know, threes speak very strongly to me here. Okay, so whatever ships you have sent out, you are waiting on the return. Virgo, this is just glorious. I would like to look at the Chariot. Why? Because these could be obstacles or this can be literal movement. Some of you may be waiting on this King of Cups to visit you. And that could be from a distance with a Sospiri. She's looking across the seas. And you do have the Chariot here, which is a card of movement. Let me see. So we've got Amore. We've got Vedovo, which is trying to get over your past. Okay, being stuck in the past in relation to anything to do with love. This is the widower. So this person may have been coming, is coming forward or overcoming any obstacles that he or she have been through. They are overcoming, and that could be, it could even be distance that we are talking about. And then we've got the hopes or fears. I mean, this is a hope card or a fear card. For me, this is a hope card, okay, and being able to overcome obstacles, because these Sibyllas are on top of the Chariot card. And you know what, I'd like to say one more thing, is that if you thought that it was not going to work out here, sorry about that, it will, okay? So we've got the card of hope. Keep the hope, it's going to happen for you. The cards are absolutely wonderful, dear Virgo. Do keep well. Thank you for being here, sending you all my love and angel blessings. All the best until I see you mid-May again. Bye for now.